Right, hello everyone. I did start this series already, but the game crashed. And in one of the ways of trying to fix it, I actually deleted the profile. It still didn't work, but I've managed to get it work now, which means I can't upload the last one. So I've had to start again. What we'll do is we'll plan out each series and whatever it is that we're going to do. Because at the moment, usually you get phone calls. You can pick up the phone and you get phone calls on people who live like over by there, over by the shops, or up the road by here. I think there's ones. I think there's a few along by here as well. I think there's some by there. I don't think there's any down by here. I think it's all like from there all the way up and around to about there-ish, somewhere by there. There's no houses by here that give you jobs, I think. I'm not 100% sure. But, since there's no jobs, yeah, every Saturday there's a rally circuit that goes on that you can involve for. But, what we're going to do is now, go into here. And I set all this up ready, so you don't have to do it afterwards. Yeah, it's going in the bucket. I'm going to go down by here, and I'm going to put this on. Because in here, you don't have a shower. See, there's a dirtiness bar in the top left. You don't have a shower, you have a sauna. So you whack it up the full heat, and that's the... Yeah. That's the thermostat, I think it's called. You can see the temperature in there. Or was that it? That's the thermostat. But that gives you the reading. Once it gets hot enough, you can pick up that, chuck it on there, steams up, cleans you. But it makes you thirsty as well. So we leave that to heat up now while we're gone. For this one, I'll leave it by here for now. We'll come back to the house now. So I'm not going through the lanes in the car. Not in the car, in the van. Because this is what we got to build. I have done it twice. The first time I had permadeath on and I died. So I wasn't too chuffed with that. Did it the second time. And what was it happened the second one? I can't remember. Was it the file didn't work or something? Or I think I lost it? Or something like that, I think. And that's what I gotta take. I'm not gonna forget that, because I did record this last time, but it buggered up. This is coming with us, because this is a fuel can for the car that we're gonna use to fill it up, because it's gonna be a totally empty tank. So I'll leave that there. We'll run over and grab the truck a minute. But I'm probably going to try and make it 30 to 40 minutes per episode for this first one, just to get things done. It might be around about that, maybe a little bit longer. But for today, it's just going to be an easy ride. We'll probably, well, we got 3,000 marks, because I think that's a currency now. I think it's a currency for this, is marks. But we'll do this. Oh, tell you what we'll do. I'll show you the tractor so you can see what that's like. Because, that's what I need to take as well. Right, I'll make sure I grab that. What I'll do is, whenever I've recorded moving the trailer, I've always done worse than when I'm not recording. I don't get it. There you are. I'll release a parking brake for now. Go into driving mode with enter key if you don't know. Tractor's probably the easiest thing to go and drive. But I say that and then I'll cock it up with reversing. You've got to give it quite a bit of a shunt. There you are. So if you do it too light, it won't do anything. I might just nap the corner on it, like. Straighten. Not shabby, not too shabby. I might pull it forward just a little bit. I might as well leave it here. I'm just gonna leave the tractor here. Add a gear on it now. Parking brake on. Exit driving mode. Yeah, we'll leave it. Yeah, I'll detach it though, because it detaches it anyway. Whenever you save the game and then you reload it again, it detaches anyway. So we can do that. We can use the axe to chop all this up and do all that stuff. But we'll grab this, because we need it. Because I'm not driving all the way down to the gas station and that. Trust me, it's a long drive. Filling up this tank takes forever. This is a sewage truck. In case you don't know anything about the game yet. Or you're new to it or whatever. That's what I was on about with the jobs earlier. That you take the sewage truck. And over on the other side, if I show you quick. You go up to here, press take hose, it automatically attaches to this. You just got to drop it into the hole in the floor, and the handle is for when you want to tip it all out, because there's nowhere really you can tip it, so you just chuck it anyway. But they pay you 1,200 marks, I think it is, for it, per one. And they all give you that. I'm pretty sure they all give you that every time. Whenever you dump the pump, the pipe down into the hole in the floor for the well. You flip that switch there. Actually, if I go driving mode, there, the hydraulic pump. You go and flip that switch and it'll start sucking it all up, and then you know when it's ready because you'll hear the bloke at the house blabber on about something and it'll come up in English subtitles if you've got the subtitles on at the bottom, and it'll give you the money. It takes a little bit, but it's not too long. About a minute or two. Come on. Hey. Right, the last time I've done this, you couldn't hear my voice over the top, so I'll try and talk a little bit louder when it comes to being in this truck. I think for my birthday, I think I'll go and try and get one of those proper microphones. I wonder if I can get one that attaches to the desk. I don't know if there's any cheap ones going out. Come on. Come on. I hate this thing sometimes, the way it drives. Stop it by here. Low ranged again. Parking brake on. We'll leave the engine running. Because sometimes you don't want to start, so. Rather than having to go for all that. Oh, that reminds me as well. First thing we're going to do. I don't know what that's spinning for. Dice. Yeah. Because you put them in the car and you can't see anything in the rear view mirror. Totally blocks it up. I'm going to leave the door open for when we come back, because that's where the whole shopping's going to go, isn't it? Every time you go out, you need to take food and drink. Because look, my thirst bar's already got. Whoa, glitch. My thirst bar's already gone up, halfway up. I'll have a quick drink now while we're here, water, but alcohol is kind of last resort because you can get drunk. And if the police catch you and stop you, you get, is it fined or, I'm not sure because I haven't had it done to me yet, thank God. I've been chased by the police before. I haven't been caught by them. I actually got chased when I was in the sewage truck. Leveled it down the highway. Yes, you've got the gasoline and diesel now. Oh, give me 1,000. Oh, the perfect amount. Well, 1,200, which I think is the highest amount it gives you. Those Christmas lights are not going in the car. Waste of space. That stuff gets you smashed if you drink that, so I'm not drinking that yet. I'm pretty sure you can put the TV on, yeah. Flipping out. He's put a real life video in there, hasn't he? Topless gun. Assume it's his gun. What the? Yeah, I can play you. Well, I'm pretty sure I can play all the music in this game because he apparently says that all the music's free, copyright free. It's all stuff that he's made. And he said that you can use it and that. It's all just stuff he chucks in and makes. Right, so we got the two gas cans, we got the food, we got... That's what I want to do. Yeah, Muppet. That's the thing you've got to keep doing, because if you bugger off, it takes a while to come back, and then you start getting hungry and thirsty and all that, so... Get the thirst bar down. Yes, you can pee as well. Right. I'm going to fill up the sewage truck as well while we're up there. I hope we, hope to God, we don't bump into the green car that levels it through the lanes. Take off the parking brake. Low air pressure gauge. But yeah, for today's episode, it'd just be a quick drive out to the shops. We'll probably end up coming back with about 1,000 marks, I think, because by the time I fill up this truck, I think that takes 1,000 or so off me. Is it 1,000 or is it something like a couple hundred? I think it's a couple hundred, because there's half a tank here, but I want to fill it up because it drains like no tomorrow. So I'll go up there and fill it up. By the time I grab a load of food and all the oils and the timing belt and all that, by the time we grab all that to go make the car, by the time we pay for it all, because last time I'd done this, I recorded it, I was stupid enough, I actually forgot about the random envelope of money, so I did it with the 3,000 marks. By the time I went up there and got everything, I forgot the green canister. I only took the diesel last time as well, so that's without filling up the green canister. And without having the random money, I come back with 600 marks, I think it was. The lowest I've ever gotten on this game of money. Usually I only get to about 1,000, 2,000 is the lowest. I never actually got down below 1,000, I don't think. I think it is 60 costing. I'm going to try and stick the speed limits because I don't want to tip this over. Because it's very hard to tip it back. I've actually got a program on the computer where you can edit the game files and you can actually re-tip it so you can put it back onto all wheels again, but it's a lot of hassle for nothing really. I'd rather just take my time and not tip it. So I'm going to try and stick the speed limits until I get the roads, I'll just level it if there's no cops about, because the cops are speed guns. And if you don't pull over, they'll follow you and chase you. But I think there's only certain roads they follow you on. I don't think they follow you up this lane up to your house. It's only on the main one that we're coming up to now. This is usually where the green one comes up. All this lane from the left to the main road, and from the right to the main road, all this lane... God, these brakes are awful. He comes up here. Drop it back a bit now. I hate this bend by year, so I'm not going to go much quicker than this. I could bring it up a bit. This is one of the two bends, and then the next one's up by year as well. I fell in this one on the way back before, and that drove me nuts. Keep it in first high gear. Because this one's a pain. It's so much of a tight lane to do. I think on your very first go out to the shops and back, I don't think you bump into him, because every time I've done it, I've never seen him on the first trip out there and back. It's only ever been from what, every other time apart from the first one. So I think it lets you off for the first trip out. But he levels it across you, and if you come across you in your car or the van, you fly through the windscreen and die, pretty much, if you do a head-on. Or you could end up swerving off to the side, going straight to a tree and die that way. There's quite a lot of ways you can die here. Die hungry, you can die of thirst. I'm not sure if you can die from being tired and dirty. I don't think they do that. Thank God. Because you've got enough to worry about as it is on here. But, it is easy to die in here. It is very easy. That's why I don't think I'm going to do the rally and all that straight away. I did turn off permadeath. So, say you go and do, like, you spend hours and hours and hours on here collecting loads of money, doing up the car. You put all the, you save up a load more money then after getting it running. Go and put all the rally kit on, all the new air intakes and bucket seats. So the bucket seats are like $5,000. Doing all that. If you die then, you lose the entire save. I thought it was just you went back to the previous save. No, you lose the entire save. Everything you do, or everything you've done on that save, you lose. So I turn that off, which means now that if I die, say if I tip this truck over now, went for the windscreen, because it is possible to do, it's just a bit harder to do in this than in the car and the van. If I tipped this over, went into a tree through the windscreen, died, the truck would stay here, but I'd spawn back at the house. So I'd have to try and get the truck back, which is very hard to do, because it's very hard to go and tip this thing back over again. Oh, there he is, he's behind us now! That's him! Look in the left mirror. You can see the green guy there. That's the first time I've seen him on the first trip out. Oh well. Hopefully he bins it on the way back. Yeah, sometimes he levels it through you so much he bins it. Away from him. I don't want him getting stuck under the axles at the back or something and pushing us off to the sides. Or something stupid like that. I'm pretty good at drifting this truck now and again. Sometimes I surprise myself. You know what I did? Absolute dipshit I am. I'd taken the longer route, I think. I went right, didn't I? Should have gone left. Because that would have took me all the way up the highway. So I took the bit more dangerous route. There's more chance of me dying on. Where's he gone? Is he still there? Or has he binned it? I think he's binned it, is he? Because he's not behind us, I think. Ooh, stop looking in the mirror. Can't see anywhere. Yes, he's not there. I think he's binned it. That's right. That means he's not going to see on the way back. Because if he bins a car, he stays in up until the next time you quit the game and reload the save. So when you save, because whenever you save the game, it quits it as well. So when you save and quit, once you come back in again, then it resets him. So if he's binned it and you want to go and take the car out, then that's the perfect time to do it, is when he's binned it. So you're more safe when you take your time. Yeah, the brakes are awful on this. They are atrocious. Oh no, I don't think I went the wrong way. No, I didn't, no. Because I should have went through the garage if I went through the garage. I should have went past the mechanic if I went the other way, the longer way, the dangerous one. So I did go the right way, I think. Pretty sure I did. Unless I did go past it, I just didn't realise. Probably did, no Oiler. No, I didn't, because I would have come in the other end of the town, wouldn't I? Yeah, so I've got the wrong way. So if you go the other way that I was just on about, you come in at the top end of the town, not the bottom. But you're coming over on the right-hand side. We're coming in from the left. From the west side, yeah, rather than the east. That's one thing you can't do with your car, is over-rev it. Because you over-rev your car, does damage. The brakes are awful. I had probably about 75-80% braking on them. Yeah, it's 10 past 7 already. pretty sure the tank's on the drive. There's Mr. Wubbub. Yeah, I have watched Squirrel do this, these videos, and that's what he calls him, is Mr. Wubbub, because you hear his music all the time, and he's here 24/7. Oh, you donut. Oh no, it doesn't matter. There's no point putting the order in, because I got no money, have I? Yeah, with this, when you want to put in orders for your car. There you go, he started again. When you put orders in for your car, you don't do it online, because this was set back a few years ago. It's 1960s? 1970s? Something like that? I'm not sure on the date that this game was set. I forgot. Late 1900s, anyway. But you don't do it by email and all that, because they didn't have electronic emails. Or much of it, anyway. Well, not electronic emails, but like mailing, ordering systems like that. So everything you ordered, you had to do by the book. Take it to the post office, send it off. And all that good stuff. Right, what I'll do is now, just in case I glitch the game out, because it doesn't like me filling up two different pumps at once. I can't remember if I'd done it before, though, filling two up at once. So what I'll do is, because it's all diesel for that, so I'd do the petrol one first quick, so I'll show you how it's done. And then I'll either time lapse, if I can do it, because I got some new recording software now. So since I got the new recording software, it does mean that I can do a lot more stuff, but I don't know how to use it. I'm using that HitFilm, I think it is. It's a really good bit of software. The free version has a lot going for it. You get a lot more from the pro that you pay for, but you still get a lot for the standard stuff. The game's actually working a bit better, because usually it's really picky on how you hold the hose up to the thing. It's picky as hell like that. Burp then, pardon me. Chuck this back in the back then. Oh, we're getting hungry. Eat that. I'll have a beer as well. Go on, chuck that over there. See, he's swaying ever so lightly. Slightly, I mean. That's not me moving the mouse, that's him. The mouse is dead still. That's him, that is. That's you chuck your orders there. I think you can do it even when the shop's shut. 89. Not bad. Right. Pay for that. I'm about to close the... Oh, God's sake. Right, I'll try not to be too long then. Come on. Stop being picky. See what I mean? The game has to be picky, doesn't it? But what I'll do is now for the truck, it takes ages to fill up the truck. From about halfway to a full, I think it's about 4 to 5 minutes, I'm pretty sure it is. Or if that's from empty to full, I'm not sure, but it takes ages. Honestly, it drags. So I'll chuck that back in the truck. Yep, it's in there. So, see that? Filling it up. Moving like a pixel at a time. So what I'll do is I'll either time lapse it here so you don't have to watch it, or what I'll do is if I can't time lapse it, I'll just cut it out. I'll just come back to it. Okay, so I'll see you guys all in a minute. Right, so we're back. That took ages. What was that, about 3-4 minutes, I think? It dragged like no tomorrow, that did. I'm hoping the shop's still open, please. I wish you could just set it to fill up. Oh, he's still open, thank you. Thank you very much. Well, thank you for visiting. What do you want to know? See, like, it's left me with pretty much nothing now. Oop. Couple of these as well. Two of them. Mozzie sprays. Got more. All of them we need. Fan belt, that's the one. One of those, one of those. That's it, I think. Told you it's a lot of money. Oh, stuff it. Might as well, innit? So he added a bit more on. I was gonna say then, where's the rest? That's stacked up nicely. What I'll do is I'll throw it all outside. I had a massive feeling he was gonna do that. The shop door's still open though. What's he done? Can't buy anything now though. I'm pretty sure this switches the pumps, which I think are those. So you can put the pump. I think you put the pumps on and that.
I don't need way back, is it?
Wait then, sorry about that. Another interruption. This is one thing I don't like, is being interrupted for these videos. It puts me off what I'm doing, and sometimes I forget about stuff on here as well then. It's, whoop, get the back, you. Sometimes some of the stuff falls out of the truck. Which really drives me nuts. He's driving me nuts at that music. If you've played the game as much as I have now, I haven't played it for that long either. I've had a couple of days, I've played quite a few hours on this. And it's just driving me absolutely nuts on it. Well, not absolutely nuts, but... enough to get near nerves. I bet some of you are like, you know, like, tell him to turn the music down. He's like, no, I'm at, you're alright. Oh, I'll show you something funny we can do with him after. When I chuck this in. Oop. Dip, 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 potato chip. There's a way you can go and piss him off. Pardon the language. I'm gonna make sure I run like hell when I do it.
By the way,
run! Ooh, that was lucky. Never do it when he got the car or the van because he can do damage. The truck, don't think it takes any damage. He's bend it, it's all over there. Oop. It's really sensitive back and forth, but not like that for when you're going left or right, is it? Hey! chuck the lights on now because it's getting dark. Put full beam on. Oh, he bended over there now. I didn't see him go back past. Yeah, they're all in the pub now. There's a white guy in the corner of the building, though. Brilliant, that is. Sometimes they level it across here. But the thing is though, when we want to get those jobs for emptying the sewage stuff out, we have to wait for them to call us. But if we're not in house, can't hear the phone and we can't go and take the call, can we? Obviously. But what I might do is, because I did promise, well, someone my mates, I said that I'd have it uploaded a day or two ago, but I couldn't do it, could I? Because the way the game was. And so what I might do is I might upload this and start filming the second one and probably chuck that one up as well, and then the third one, and I start building the car. I'm hoping, so I'm gonna get some money in now and start building the car. I got everything I need from the shop. It was a good, and it's only just because I managed to have it's only because of the fact I managed to go and have that random lot. Yeah, everything's still here. So I got that random money gift thing, and I managed to give me the full amount. I think there's a full amount you can get from it. Yeah, I think down that way then. Oh, there he is, he's binned it. He has, he binned it on the way back. Brilliant. He's on the left hand side back there then. Whoop. Whoa. Was lucky then. I wouldn't have been happy if that was gonna go very, very badly. I don't know. Way back. I hit the mic. Again. The second time I've hit it now. It's because it's literally right above the wheel. Sometimes I catch it. And I go, get on the road, you stupid vehicle! Neutral, parking brake on. Let's sort this stuff out quick. That way. Yep. Yeah, that'll do. Shut up, low fuel gauge. Low air pressure, I mean. I'm definitely going to be taking my time now. See how much of this we gotta drive? Whoa! I calls that myself then. Get up. Oh, I didn't say either. My driving's probably really accurate with the steering and that, because I'm not using the mouse and keyboard. I'm actually using my G27 racing wheel. just steering wheel. I'm not sure if they class it as a racing wheel or steering wheel. I'm pretty sure it's a racing wheel because it's got the flappy panels and everything on it as well for racing. But it has got, if you don't know about the G27, probably one of the best steering wheels going for PC and app right now. It's got the full, is it 190 degrees turn, I think it is, 190? I think it's that. It's got flappy panels, it's got six programmable buttons on the front. It's got the full throttle pedal, brake pedal and clutch pedal. It's got the gear stick with six gears and reverse, which you have to push in, move across and down for the reverse. And on that there is 12 programmable buttons on that as well. So you've got a lot of choices and mapping buttons to do things. I think on the gear stick, on the panel below with the buttons, I think I've got like the lights and the wipers and things set to that. It doesn't really matter about putting the wipers on, because it's not like trucks in where it starts raining and it actually goes onto the windscreen and you use the wipers to actually wipe the screen. It doesn't work, it just rains and that's like a visual effect, that's it. See, look, man, it's because I keep rushing. I don't like sitting and doing this long driving stuff on this game. It's not the type of game I want to be doing this. I come here to build a car, that's why I tried to do as little journeys as possible. That's why I grabbed all the food in the end. Gonna go then. I think this is the last turn now before we turn back onto our one. Yes, it is. There we are. Turn left by you now. Just straight up the hill. I just cut across the grass by you. Hopefully, fingers crossed, the game won't crash. Again, I think I just got to turn off the steering stuff because it fiddles with the game files, I think. So as long as I get rid of the turn off the force feedback stuff on the main screen and get rid of the steering file, that when I done that, it suddenly worked again. So hopefully if it happens again, I can do that and hopefully it'll work again then when I do it again. But fingers crossed it doesn't happen again because it's less work for me. And you never know if the same thing's gonna work, the same solution's gonna work twice, do you? So anything can go wrong. Because I think it's still like alpha stage, I think, or something. I'm not sure if it's a full release game or... because it's still quite buggy for a full release game. It's not too bad, it's pretty stable, but... I probably wouldn't have released it as a full stable game yet, because it's not fully stable. There are bugs and things, but it's not a lot. It's actually a pretty good game. There's a lot of stuff they need to improve and change on, but it's not too bad, not too shabby. Look at that, as soon as you turn up back of the house and that, look how much the frame rate's dropped now. Actually, I'm going to move it out of the way. I forgot if we could go for that tree or not then, so I panicked. Yeah, because I don't think we need the lorry again now for a bit. Lights off, engine off. You can drain the battery on this as well. I'm not sure if you can do it for the truck, but I know that you can do it for the car. You can pretty much damage a car in every single way. But What one have we drunk from? Not that one. It was the one I just thrown out, wasn't it? Yeah, because that one's full as well. So I chucked the wrong one out, I think. Haven't I? Have I? No. Right. Leave that there on the edge of the desk. Yes, I know you're tired. Oh, he's actually quite thirsty as well. Sort his thirst out quick. He'd be dying for a pee now, you will. Yeah, you always leave a case of beer in each vehicle. That's what I try to do. So I'll chuck one in the van as well. And I want to leave some food in there as well, but I'll grab that in a minute. I'll shuttle this for now. Did I put it in there, or did I forget to take it out? What the hell is it? It hasn't gone. Where is it? Glitch inside the truck. Did I pick it back up and put it in the truck? I'm pretty sure I did. That's brilliant, isn't it? I lost the diesel canister. Oh, I don't want to get in the vehicle. I want to look through. It's not falling out the back. I am absolutely certain I put it back in the truck. Yes, yeah, it's fallen out. I told you stuff likes to fall out of the vehicles, didn't I? The game's actually quite dark. No, I can't see much. We'll have a look in the morning. I think. Well, we don't need it yet, do we? But unless I take it out now, quick. There's a green can. Nothing in there. This doesn't go in here, does it? Derp. Open. And you open. Do this. Chuck up there. I'm gonna chuck this stuff up here out of the way. So I want the table to be clear, really. If I can get it to happen. Set this up by here. Yeah, all these spray cans, it used to spray the car, but because I default selected red in the menu when I remade this file, that it set everything as red. If you don't choose a colour at the start, it's default. It's total default colour. I think it's like a greyish white thing. Or it's white. But you can get the rust and all that off eventually. That's the exhaust pipe down here. part of it. That's the exhaust where they are. Well. I am absolutely certain that I put that canister back in there. It's going to bug me now. Because I'll probably forget about it next time I do this. Actually, doing the next episode now, and I could do. Go away. I know that would be bloody him. My mate calling. CBF8 to talk to him right now. He's one of these ones that can fucking moan a bit. Because I don't find him ages. Moan. Oh, bloody hell, shut up, man. What we'll do is open a bag. All this up in here. You don't have to do this, but I just prefer it to be tidy, really. So it's not everywhere. It's a bit decent. Whoa! Didn't want to go that far. Actually, I think I'll just keep it all in there. I was going to chuck it all in the freezer, but nah, stuff it. Just chuck it all over here, innit? In the blood. All that gangster talk. Ooh. Flat. Up against the wall. Flat. Cans. Mozzie spray. Because you probably hear the bzzz and all that. It gets on people's nerves. Because this game is like a trolling game. It's not made for the faint hearted. It loves to troll. Honestly, it'll sit there, and if it could, it would go tra-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la every time it annoys you. Yeah, it's not bad, this. What we do is, hopefully. Hey, chuck that up there. We should be able to go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I don't think we need all of those bottles, but might as well, isn't it? See that here now? I didn't dump it somewhere. I'm pretty sure it fell out the vehicle. I should have checked. What's time? Oh, it's gone midnight. There was something else, wasn't there? Hold on. Trusty torch. I use this to do in the engine as well. Because at some point you have to go down here and look up. So usually I'll set it down there looking up at the vehicle so you can actually see it all like lit up. So you can see it all lit. Get it? Lit. Right. This stuff we don't need till the engine's actually built, so this is just going to sit you on standby for now. Till we need it. I thought it's better to grab it now, get it the way with. At least you know where we stand financially. And actually, we don't need to do the jobs, because I'd totally forgotten about that money that we get from that gift voucher thing. So, you got 1,490 marks. technically, the next episode I could build the car. But I will warn you, I'm not the best at building cars, mate. I will probably follow a video, cause I've had to follow Squirrel, cause he's done his video, and I've had to follow it. Was that green canister gone? I was on a day. The date. I was gonna say the floor and the desk at the same time. The table and the desk. Sorry. So I'm just gonna take this out. Drop it back there. I'll see for now then. Oh, hold on, it's not that one. It's this one first. Not light off. I can't see anything. Right, so we'll go off in here now. Sauna's finished, probably. Yep, temperature's up, but I always keep it on. Come on in. Yeah. Let's bring this dirtiness level down. See, that one drops down in chunks, but it will keep going. It will slowly come down. Come on. Yeah, that'll do for now then. Getting dirty tracks more than Mozzie's as well. As it's towards the end of the episode, I'm not going to bother using them again now. It's a bit pointless. We'll have something to eat. We'll probably have some sausages since we've got tons of them. So we'll have sausage. Let me go. I'll tell you what, let's crack open a beer. See how much you have to do just to go and keep these bars down. Press P, obviously. Press P to P. Quick drink. Lovely Lucozade. Now, when it goes to this, you can hold P and do it, or you can just keep tapping it and do like bits, or just hold it, and then I just let it stop. There, yeah. It doesn't stop until the bar's fully gone. Not the bathroom light off. One thing you want to do every night that I almost forgotten in: disconnect the phone, because you get some drunk bloke calling you up in the night because he wants to have a lift back home. So your fatigue level will go all the way down, so you're not tired anymore, and you'll be up at like 1 a.m. So your sleeping pattern will all go wrong. Tell you what I could do. If I did the firewood, we could put the parts in that we want. Should we? Yeah. Tell you what then. If I do catalogue, we'll order that. Because I wanted that. Because that looks cool on the back of the car, that does. Go for... yeah, that one we'll go for. And we need that, because that's to help us tune the engine for later. Go for that and that. His RPM gauge when you're racing to show you when to change the light comes on. That you can get. We're not going into all this stuff yet. all these turbos and that. And yeah, the thing is though that we can't get this type of stuff and add more power in without having more air in the vehicle, so that's one thing we'd have to get first. I'm not going for that wheel yet, because it's, look at the price of it. Look at that, I told you, 5,000. And you get belts as well, properly now. Well, any of those, you can chuck those in. And then, if you have a crash, there's very little chance of you dying. Yeah, so we leave the envelope there now, for the morning. But, yeah, I hope you all enjoyed the first episode of that. If you did, just leave a like. You can drop a comment and let me know what you think so far, or if there's anything you want to see me try on this game, or even stuff that you want me to do in one of the episodes eventually. Then just drop it in the comments. But apart from that, if you enjoyed, then smack that like button and make sure you hit that subscribe button so you stay up with the latest content that I send out. I'll most likely do, I'll upload this one out tonight if I can. Hopefully I can, fingers crossed, if the internet's free. And then, I might go and upload, I'll see if I can record and upload the next one for tonight. I could do, because it's only 10 to 8. So if I give my mate a call back around about 9, because he doesn't usually go to bed till 10, because he's in work in the mornings. He starts at 5, 6 in the morning. So he's in bed by 10. He only has 6 hours sleep. He shouldn't do. He should have at least 7 or so. Yeah, so if I call him around about 9, he'll probably stay on the phone until about 9, 10. I'm making sure he's doing it in his minutes instead of mine this time. But I'll do that. Yeah, I'll see if I can get these two videos done for you. We'll go and do a bit of money, post that, find where that diesel can is for the next episode. So it's diesel can, post envelope for the parts, and doing the firewood to get some money in. And you actually get 3,000 from doing that, and you can do it as much as you like, I'm pretty sure you can. But apart from that, then I'll catch you all in the next one. Happy car building. Oh, yeah.